Hello guys, I welcome you all to my channel. In this video tutorial, we will design car jack in SolidWorks. So let's start this. First of all, we will design the base of the car jack. So here we will select front plane, catch, we will select line, draw a straight line. Okay. Now draw some other lines like this. End chain similarly like this. Now select 3-point arc. Okay, now draw a line, select, now draw another 3-point arc. Okay, now we will give it some dimension. Go to some more dimension, make it 40. Similarly, make this 40. Make it 5. Now make these two lengths equal. Okay. Now give this dimension 20. Okay, draw a center line from the origin. Make sure it is vertical. Yes, it is vertical. Now define a symmetric relation. Okay. Now, okay, we have already defined the dimension. Okay. We just delete it. Okay, now make these two arcs equal and give them a radius of 22. Accept it. Okay, you can see our relation is not fully defined. This is because of this point. So we don't need to define it, we will just adjust it as we want. Okay, it's okay now. So go to extrude boss base, select this sketch. Okay, extrude it 30 mm, select. Okay, we did not made any hole here, so we will first go to edit sketch. We will draw some circles. Go to some R dimension. Make this 27. And make this 13. Make this 13. Similarly, with this circle, make this 13. And make this 27. And make it 6 mm, select. Now make these two circles equal. Okay, it's okay now. Edit this extruded workspace feature, clear selection, and we will select this contour now. Select OK. So now you can see all four bolts has been created. Okay, now go to right plane, sketch, make it normal. Now draw a corner rectangle up to this length. Dimension it. With this edge, it should be 5 mm. Similarly, with this edge, it should also be 5 mm. Now it's okay. Now go to features, extruded cut, and make it through all both. Accept it. Okay. It's okay now. Now go to appearances, go to metals, iron, and make this cast iron. Accept it. Now we will save it as base. Now we will create the legs of the car jack. So select front plane, sketch. Now here select straight slot and draw a straight slot like this. Okay, now we will dimension it. Go to smart dimension. Now give this line dimension 70. Okay, now give this length 11 mm. Okay, now we will draw two circles for the bolts here and here and make them equal. Okay, now give them dimension 6 mm. Okay. Okay, now we will extrude it. Extrude this part up to 3 mm. Okay, now again give it cast iron and save it as leg. Okay, now we will draw the top of the car jack. So select front plane, sketch. Okay, here we will again select straight slot, draw a slot like this, make this 34 mm. Okay, now make this dimension 15. Okay, now we need again two holes. Make this dimension equals to 4 mm. Similarly here. These two points should be at 4 mm. Now make this equals to 6. Okay, and make these two circles equal. Accept it. Okay, we will extrude it up to 20 mm. Accept it. Okay, now we will draw some features on this face. So go to sketch and sketch. Okay, draw a center line like this and draw a circle. Okay, now make this equals to 5 mm. Extrude it up to 4 mm or 5. Okay, now again give it some appearance. Now we will create the nut. So go to front plane, sketch. Okay, select slot. Now draw a slot like this. Now we will give it some dimensions. Make it 14. And make this radius 7. Accept it. Now draw a circle at the center point and make the radius 6. Accept. Okay, now we will extrude it. Make it 14 mm. Okay, now we will sketch on this plane. Sketch, make it normal. Okay, draw a center line like this and draw a circle at the center. Make it 6 mm. Make sure it should be at 7 mm. Okay, and also 7. Okay, it is all right. Now go to features, extrude cut, and select through all and accept it. Okay, now it looks fine. Now say give it some appearance. Make it cast iron. Okay, now save it. Now we will create the screw or threaded rod of our car jack. So select front plane, sketch. Now draw a circle of 11. Accept. Go to features and extrude it up to 14 mm. Accept. Now select this face and sketch. Now here draw a circle. Make it 9 mm and extrude it to 0.3 mm. Accept. Okay, now again sketch on this face and draw a circle of 6 mm radius, sorry, diameter, and extrude it up to 200 mm. Okay, accept it. Okay, select right plane. Make it normal and draw a circle like this and make it equals to 1.4 mm, except now extruded, make it 40, except okay, now edit the sketch and now go to top plane and sketch on it, make it normal. Okay, now draw a line from the center of the circle. We'll just draw okay. Now draw a perpendicular line like this. Select. Now give it a fillet. Okay, let's make it 2. Okay, let's first define this dimension 40. And make this up to 10. Or let's make this 15. Okay. Now give it a fillet and make this 8. Accept it. Now exit the sketch. Now go to loft boss base. Sorry, go to swept boss base and select this sketch and this path, accept. Now our handle is ready. Now we will give it some threads. Now go to features, hole wizard, and go to thread. Okay. Now select this edge and make it 200. Make this now make it extrude thread, accept it. Here you can see our threads are ready. Okay, now we need to cut this extra portion of thread. So we will go top plane and sketch and draw a line. Okay, now extrude cut in both direction and accept. Okay, now it looks fine. Now our road is ready. So save this. Okay, now we need to make the upper part on which the car will support. Go to front plane, sketch, select line, and draw a line like this. Now select 3-point arc and draw an arc. Now we will make it 4 and make this 10. And make this equals to 10 also. Okay, accept it. Now go to features, devolve pose space, and select this edge. Accept. Okay. Okay, now go to features and select shell command. Select this face, make it 0.5 or 0.3. Accept it. Now go to front plane, sketch, draw a corner rectangle. Okay, draw a center line and make this 2 points and this line symmetric. Make this length up to 8 mm. Make this height up to 3.4. Right. Now go to features, extrude cut, and make this through all bone. Accept it. Okay, now similarly on this face, center line. Make this to symmetric. Make this dimension 8 and this height 3.4. Features, extrude cut, and through all bone. Accept. Okay, now our upper portion has been ready. Okay, let's now save it. Okay, now we will make the bold. So go to sketch, front plane, and draw a polygon. Okay, make it 6. Accept. Now dimension this circle 10 mm. Go to features and extrude it up to 4 mm. Accept it. Now select this face and sketch. Now make this sketch show and select this circle and convert it. Now go to features, extrude it cut. Okay, now select this box, flip side to cut. Now make it 30 degree. Accept. Okay, now it looks fine. Now draw a sketch on this face. Draw a circle. Make it 7. Now extrude it up to make this dimension 36. Accept. Okay. Okay, now go to fillet and go to chamfer. Select this edge and make it 1. Accept. Okay, go to appearances and make it cast iron. Okay, again go to appearance here, go to miscellaneous, go to pattern and select this screw thread pattern and select this extruded bore space too. Okay, now go to this option here and select this screw thread and make it edit appearance. Okay, now make this square a little bit big. Okay, now it looks fine. Except okay, now our bolt is ready now. Okay, now we need to create another type of bolt. So select front plane, sketch, draw a polygon, extrude it up to 10 mm. Okay, let's first dimension it. Make this circle 10 mm and extrude it up to 4 mm. Step. Now sketch on this face. Make this sketch show and convert this circle. Okay, now you can hide this sketch, previous sketch. Okay, go to features, extruded cut, flip side to cut, and make this drop 30 degrees. Accept. Okay, select this face and sketch. Now draw a circle and make it 6 mm, or actually make it 7. Okay, now extrude it up to 6 mm. Now go to chamfer, select this edge, step. Okay, here we have 1 mm and 45 degrees. Okay, now give it some metal, give it cast iron, make the whole body. Okay, now we will make a thread pattern. Here go to miscellaneous and pattern, make it thread. Okay, now go to appearance here and edit this appearance, make it a little bit large. Okay, now accept. Now save this file. Okay, now we will create the nut. Now draw polygon, make this circle 10 and extrude it up to 4 mm. Accept it. Sketch on this face, make this sketch show and extrude it, sorry, convert it, convert the circle, this circle. Okay, now you can hide this sketch. Okay, go to feature and extruded cut, flip side to cut, and make this drop 30 degrees. Accept. Select this face and again make it show and convert this sketch. Go to features, extruded cut, flip side to cut, and make this drop. Accept. Okay, now it looks fine. Now hide this sketch. Now again we will make a hole
a sketch and draw a circle and make it 7 mm. Accept it. We will extrude cut and make it through all. Okay. Now we will give it some material, metal, iron and cast iron. Okay, now again go to appearance and here miscellaneous pattern and give it screw thread. Okay, now here go to display manager and select edit appearance. Now we will make this thread a little bit big. Now it looks fine. Okay, now we will save it. Okay, now we will complete our assembly portion. So in assembly, go to insert components. Okay, now browse components. Okay, now select these components we just designed. Open. Okay, now make this base fix. Okay, now it is fixed. You can see the component is fixed. Okay, now this is the top portion. As you can see the top, so we will apply width mate, advanced mate, hair width mate. Now select this side, and then this side, and this side. Accept it. Okay. Now we will adjust the position of this top and bottom. Here, select the right plane of the base. And our right plane of the top. Okay. Now accept it. Now it is aligned. Okay, now here press Ctrl and drag this component. We need 8 legs. So drag it 8 times. So here we have 5. Okay, one more. Okay. Oh, make it a little bit above. Okay, now go to mate, mechanical mates, and here hinge mate. Now select this edge and this edge and this face and this face. Okay, now make it anti-aligned. Okay, here you can see, you can also get this similar action by applying two different mates, concentric mate and then coincident mate between this face and this face. But here we will use hinge mate. Now similarly with these two circles, okay, we have to apply hinge mate. Select mate, hinge mate, okay. This way and this way. Now it is okay. Okay, similarly with select hinge mate, okay. Okay, now similarly we will apply hinge mate with these circles right here, here mate, mechanical mate, hinge mate, and select this circle and this circle. Okay, actually clear the selection, select this circle and this circle, this face and this face. It's okay now. Similarly with this face, accept. Similarly here, and the last one, except. Okay, we just made a mistake. We actually have to make this edges and this face, make it anti-aligned, except. Okay, here clear the selection. Okay, hinge mate, these two edges and these two faces, anti-line, accept. Okay, so now we have, okay, okay, now again we have to apply some hinge mates. Go to mechanical mate, hinge mate. Okay. Now it is working. Okay. Okay, now we have to copy this component because we need two nuts. Okay. So now we will define its position. Okay, we will apply width mate first. Select this face. Okay, select width face first, and then select these two faces. Accept. Now you can apply concentric mate. Similarly with this one, advanced mate, width mate, select these two faces, and then select these two faces, accept. Now go to standard mate. Select this circle and this circle. Make them concentric. Okay. Now make this circle and this circle concentric. Okay, we don't, basically we have to make this concentric with this circle. Accept it. Okay, now made this face with this face. Accept it. Okay, here you can see why we made the bolts with less length, because of this rod. Okay, now we have to apply screw mates. Okay, here go to mechanical mates. Okay, first make this part isolate so that we can select its inner face. Now go to mates, mechanical mate, here select skew mate and select this face. Now exit and now select this inner face, accept it. Okay, now we will see if it is working. Here you can see it is working. Okay, now we will add some bolts and the toe portion. Okay, now we will insert the nut and bolts. So let's copy these nuts first. Okay, now these four for the base. And these four are for the top here. Okay, let's mate this. Here mate this with this and make it concentric. Accept it. Okay, now mate this face with this face. Accept it. Okay, now again mate here this face with this circle here, make it concentric. Okay, now mate this face with this face, coincident. Okay, okay, now mate this one with this one. And mate this face with this face. Accept. Similarly, mate this one with this one here. This face with this face. Accept. Okay, we need only four. Okay, we will just delete them. Okay, now similarly copy these nuts and make them four. And now make this face with this and make it concentric. Made this face with this face. Now made this face with this. Now made this face. Okay. Now we will insert these small balls here, and we will require 4 of them. Here now made. Accept. Made this one with this one. Accept. Okay, now made this face with this one and make it reverse. Accept. Similarly made this face with this one here and reverse its direction. Accept. Now made this face with this one. Okay, now we are left only with the top portion here. Okay, we will draw a circle so that we can define concentric mate. Okay. Sketch on top plane. Now draw a circle. Accept it. Exit sketch. Okay, now select this. Now mate this circle we just draw and this face. Accept it. Okay. Just drag it a little bit down. Okay, now we will mate this surface. And this face. Make them tangent. Accept. Okay, now our assembly is ready. Okay, we will just give this upper part also some metal, make it steel. Here you can see our model is working perfectly. So if you like the video, then subscribe the channel and share it with your friends. Thank you.